Hey, good afternoon, folks. This is Bob Bhatia speaking for TrueCharts.com, weekend of July 25th, and this is a weekly market update. We are going to try to keep it pretty short today, like maybe 10 to 12 minutes, quickly go over some things. So the plan is to discuss again the DIA, the QQQ, how that reacted last week. We also will talk about AMD, which was one of our picks last week. Did very well this week. We were long. And we think it's going higher. It actually broke out of a base. And thank God to Intel's news. We actually had closed our short and long on Intel, fortunately right on time, because we knew their earnings were coming. AMD has earnings next week, so we will be careful about that. But we still like the stock because we think from a valuation perspective relative to its peers like Nvidia, it's pretty cheap. So we think that stock could easily go to $80. We like it. And then we talked about last week, Moderna. We closed our position next morning when we didn't like it, although we think it's at excellent support right now, 73, so we are watching it closely. We closed partial NVAX, the position of ours. We kept the other half open. And we're going to talk about bank stocks. We indicated that those stocks are not going to be doing well. We think there's a lot of risk, and actually they did not perform well last week. And the Dow did pretty well overall, and the Dow stocks held up pretty well. If you look at the big names like Caterpillar, Deere, those stocks held up pretty well, even Disney. So those things are doing well. And then the casino stocks, you might have probably seen, they were dropping like a rock, which was what we had predicted. And so they're still falling, and we still don't like them, but we would keep an eye on them to see if there's any sort of turnaround coming. Okay, so that's so let's quickly get into it. We're trying to keep the broadcast short today, so let's look at DIA first, and we'll quickly show you a few things. So if you remember, what we said last week was we expected this to break out, but what it actually did was fall. And if you look here, it's at critical support right now. So RSI is falling, buying is sort of, you know, not looking pretty good. MACD is sort of neutral, and then, you know, the Williams percentage R is also sort of like flattening out. So we don't know how this is going to play out. There's quite a few earnings coming next week from big name stocks, so we'd be very sort of mindful here. Again, it could do this, you know, take off here, so just be careful. That's what our recommendation is. Let's look at QQQ. Oh no, sorry, not QQQ. And then what you saw was heavy distribution about 5 days ago, which was this bar right here. And then you have this very characteristic, this is a very characteristic pattern. What happens is you have a pullback, and then you have dip buyers that buy, and they ramp up the stock, the stocks that are part of the QQQ, so the QQQ ramps. But you see there's a divergence in the RSI, like you see a lower RSI. So that sort of tells you that there was not big strength in this buying. Also, the MACD had turned negative, even though the check-in money flow was showing heavy buying. We still think there's, you know, some buying going on, but there's high risk here, like you said, primarily because earnings are coming out next week. And look what happened here. The QQQ bounced right off of its 30-day. Okay, very, very critical support. It's been 30-day. You know, you can see it's been critical support. So if it breaks here, we think there's high risk. Let's quickly look at the weekly chart on the Qs and see what they look like. You can see it's pulling back. It had a higher bar, higher high, lower high and lower low than the previous bar. So that tells you the trend is sort of, for the short term, trending. So the support is around this 13-week line. You can see here 13-week is around 240. So this is about at least a minimum 15 point and possibly all the way down to its 30-week, which is around 220. So there's possible risk here. Again, be mindful, you know, these because of earnings, we'd be careful. And the weekly MACD is still positive, but we would be watching this carefully. Let's quickly look at Microsoft. So let's see how that chart looked, right? So just for sake of overall indication on the market. So broke 30-day, look at it. Support, and then broke. Okay, that's not a good sign. MACD turned negative. Your check-in money flow is going negative. Be careful. I would start taking profits here. We think there could be a bounce here, but we think the trend is down to here, approximately around 190, between 180 and 190. And let's look at what is the other big name that reported, Microsoft. And I think there was, let's look at Amazon just for the sake of, it's reporting next week, I think. Again, broke support here, critical. look at this key support was the 20 day broke that, looked like it closed above it on Friday, but again indications are all negative. See, the MACD is going negative, the chicken money flow is sort of withering out. So always, like I say, it's very critical to watch the moving averages. They're like fantastic for trading, absolutely fantastic. We talk about quickly about AMD. We picked this last week, if you remember. We said it's consolidating, and typically when there's a convergence or confluence of all these moving average lines, either the breakout will be big or the breakout will be to the downside or the upside. And guess what happened? Intel's news, bad news of launching these processors late with the most latest technology, the 7 nanometer they call it, was delayed. And I think they're going to have huge challenges because AMD is far ahead because they're using TSMC as their primary source for manufacturing. And look at the volume, huge volume. Okay, we did actually go long. We are going to add to our Monday position. Okay, we are going to add more to our position. So we picked this perfectly. We said it's a nice consolidation. We looked at the weekly chart. We said the weekly chart was indicating that the move was going to come up. Just if you would have listened to us, you would have made over 20% return, okay, just on this one stock. So we're trying to teach you guys how to use technical analysis to make trading decisions, okay? So please use this to your advantage, okay? So I will not do this without, I don't trade without technicals. Very simple rule, okay? So look at the money flow, huge. We think this could be a huge move. This could all the way, if the earnings are good, it could take off to $90, okay? And I think Intel's news was terrible. So let's look at Tesla. Fortunately, Tesla broke down. Okay, look at it, broke its 13 day. It's at critical support now, 20 day. If it breaks here, it could go easily to 30 and then 50 day. Okay, so if you hold it, we would get out of it. And then we were talking about Intel. Intel broke down. Look at that, broke down. We were short actually. We had closed it because the indicators had gone positive. So fortunately we closed. We made a little money, but not that much. But our short call was correct, right? It was bouncing off 200-day support. It could have gone either way. We didn't want to take the risk, so our call was correct. But we were long AMD, so that worked out in our favor. Let's look at the bank stock. So I want to show you JP Morgan. I just look at the big names, holding very nicely. It's a good stock to trade. It's got good option premium, decent option premium, so we like it. You know, I think there's risk here. I would be very careful. I would put a stop below 90. That's still 10% down from here. So, and then Bank of America is also looking sort of okay. It follows JP Morgan. It might break up, so we'll have to see what happens. I think the employment benefits that are ending is probably playing a risk factor here. Also, they may extend it, but we don't know what the extent is. I've heard like half, or maybe, you know, how they limit the income, people who get it based on income. So there's a lot of things rattling around in that, from the government side. So let's look at, I just looked at JP Morgan. I'm gonna look at Wells Fargo. So let's see how many minutes it's been. Trying to avoid going over. It's about 8 minutes, 30 seconds. Again, Wells Fargo still bouncing on support. You know, I don't like the stock personally. I hate this bank. So it's up to you guys. If you like to trade it, trade it. There's some bunny buying is coming in here. I think they replaced some of their chief financial officers. I think everybody thinks that that's going to help. KLA Instruments, it's a big equipment manufacturer. Look, it broke. Look at this. Huge trend up. 30, 30, 30, broke 30 day. It's at 50 days, below 50 day. Okay, 50 day is at 189.59. It's very close. It's a buck below. If it breaks that, it's going to 170. Watch it. Be careful. We think that Intel news impacted this, and probably their capital expenditure is going down. So, Lam Research is a good stock. If you look here again, bounce exactly off 20 day. So, if you're trading during the day, and you see that things are going to touch, like Friday was a beautiful day to trade. It was fantastic. Everything pulled back, and then Apple rallied $9. I mean, just think $9 for a stock. I mean, if you had bought 1,000 shares, made $9,000. Okay, simple. Or you could have just bought the calls, and you would have made a huge return on that. And we did buy calls on AMD. That's what we did. Here's Apple. Looked like it bounced back. You know, bouncing off support. This is critical. So 50 days is going to be its next critical support. So quickly, let's go to the casino stocks. So we like AMD. We'll show you Moderna because we had recommended it and we closed it. We didn't like the price action that day, so we just closed it at around 87. We broke even on that part of the trade, but the other part we sold, we made money on it. And then as soon as we closed it, we know it was going to pull back. And look, right, if you see here, bounced off 50 day. So we are watching it closely. We are not sure because they lost a patent decision on Friday, so we think that's possible risk. We like NVAX. We still own it. So we're going to see. We suspect it'll probably pull back here because look at it. It's run away from 20 to 150 bucks. Okay, that's not a joke. It's 7x move. All right, that's a 7-bagger. Okay, and if you really look from here, it's a more than a 10-bagger. Okay, so that tells you that this stock has to pull back. So we are not concerned because we've written covered calls on it. So even if it gets called away, we are not too concerned about it. And plus, they're expecting some news next week, so we'd rather be out of the position than hold it. The other one I like, actually, I've been watching it closely. I like this company, Match. So it broke, and I'm waiting for it to fall to around 80 to buy it because it's got a lot of support at its 200 days. So keep an eye on this one. It's got good option premium. It works very well. That's a good stock. And there was one more. We're looking at some energy stocks, MPC, Marathon Petroleum. We're starting to watch them, okay? We're not buying them yet, all right? So keep an eye on that. MUSA, I don't know what happened here. I'm not going to worry about it. Dominion Energy looks okay. And CVX, Chevron Texaco looks okay. And then Wynn, let's look at Wynn, the casino stocks. We talked about how they were going to be weak. Guess what? We told you last week we made money. Now it's pulling back. It's got quite a bit of support here. Again, good stock to trade, not an investment because they don't pay any more dividends. So that's out of the picture. Las Vegas Sands again broke 50 day. We think it could go lower. I think Las Vegas is going to get impacted quite a bit. Penn National Gaming. I'm surprised the stock is holding up. I think because I think they do, they take slot machines, not slot machines, you know, they do betting on horse racing games and stuff like that. I believe that's why it's holding up. Not sure. Anyway, I think it's a casino stock, so reasonable. And then El Dorado Resorts, ERI. Surprising this is holding up, again bounced off 50 day. All right, so what we are thinking is next week is going to be a very, very interesting week because you got Amazon earnings, Google earnings, a lot of big tech companies are going to be reporting. So be very careful. This is Google stock. Who knows what's going to do? I think Facebook is also probably reporting next week. Facebook actually broke support, I think. Yep, look, broke 50 day. Very difficult to say here, but I think it could go all the way to 200. So the theme of next week is earnings, what stocks, which stocks to buy. You know, be careful. I would take some profits here on the NASDAQ stocks. And then I like AMD still. I think it could go higher because it broke out of a nice big base. And then I want to quickly talk about gold. We've been harping gold since 1100. Gold has gone up to, look at it, longest consolidation we have been harping. We've been talking about it since 2018, okay, so this is not new to me. So I've been long physical gold, so that's how I look at gold. So we liked gold very much, and once they started printing money, this just took off like a rocket. Some of my friends bought this ETF, GLD. We recommended it to them, and they bought it, and it's doing very, very well. So I still like gold. I think now the next big stop is going to be 2,500. Okay, 2000 is going to face quite a bit of resistance, but then it'll probably take off 2500. Anyway, I want to stop today. Thank you very much for listening. And let us know if you have any questions. Just email me at truecharts.com@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Twitter at truecharts. I put some recommendations out there as long and shorts. And then also we are short Shopify heavily. We are going to be looking at shorting some other things. We are not sure which ones. We are looking at maybe some software stocks. But Shopify is one of our big shorts, so we are going to stay short that stock. And then if you have any comments, please leave them in the video below. Do subscribe, spread the word. We're still working on the site updates. They'll be coming soon. So appreciate you checking in and watching. Thanks again.